Preparing the networking and directory service infrastructure is the first step in deploying a SharePoint website in the Amazon Web Services cloud. This video will show you how to launch the network and Active Directory stack with a CloudFormation template. The template is a text file with a .json file extension written in JavaScript object notation, or JSON. The AWS CloudFormation service uses the information in it to create a stack of resources. Launching the network and Active Directory stack creates the necessary AWS cloud resources for configuring a secure virtual network and directory services for a multi-tiered SharePoint server farm. The template sets up a virtual private cloud with subnets and two availability zones. It deploys Active Directory to provide authentication and DNS services. It configures Windows Server instances as remote desktop gateways and deploys network address translation instances. And it implements network and instance security mechanisms. To launch the stack with sample template 1, open the companion document and scroll down. Mouse over the Launch Stack button for this stack and click the US East Northern Virginia region. This opens the Create Stack wizard and loads sample template 1. On the Select Template page, give the stack a name. This example uses AD in VPC. In the Provide a Template URL box, template 1 infrastructure with ad.json should already be pasted. Click Continue. On the Specify Parameters page, enter the name of a key pair you previously created as security credentials. You can optionally type in passwords for the domain administrator, SharePoint server administrator in restore mode, or accept the defaults. You can change the defaults for most of the other parameters to match your organizational standards. Check the box labeled, "I acknowledge that this template may create IAM resources." Click Continue. For this example, skip the Add Tags page and click Continue. On the Review page, make sure all the information is correct. If you need to change anything, click the Edit Stack, Edit Parameters, or Edit Notification links. Then click Continue. This launches the stack creation process. Click Close. In CloudFormation Manager, you can follow the progress of stack creation by clicking the Events tab. You can update the page periodically by clicking the Refresh button. To see more events, you can enlarge the stack pane. When the stack status is Create Complete, click the Outputs tab of the CloudFormation console. The Elastic IP addresses of the two remote desktop gateways are displayed in the Value column. Use these IP addresses to connect to the domain controllers via remote desktop protocol to verify or modify Active Directory and DNS configuration. You have now deployed one virtual private cloud spanning two availability zones with 8 private and 2 public subnets, 2 Microsoft Windows Server 2008 R2 instances serving as the primary and backup domain controllers and DNS servers, 2 Microsoft Windows Server 2008 R2 instances serving as remote desktop gateway servers, 2 network address translation instances, and 1 internet gateway. To customize this installation, you can download the CloudFormation template and modify it to meet your requirements. The Advanced Implementation Guide tells you how. The next step in deploying a SharePoint website in the Amazon Web Services cloud is to create a customized Amazon machine image of a SQL Server 2008 R2 database server.